I got broads in Atlanta, just to put me in the family. Credit cards in the scammers, hitting the licks in the van. Legacies, family, way and see them like a panda. Going out like a... In this video, I'm going to be covering Kanye West and what Mark Dice has to write about him in his book, Illuminati in the Music Industry. Mark Dice also has a YouTube channel. If you want more information on some of the topics he likes to cover, I highly suggest that you go follow him. So let's see what he has to write about Kanye. Another one of the biggest Illuminati wannabes is Kanye West, who burst onto the music scene in 2004 with his single, Jesus Walks, which got mainstream airplay, giving the impression that Kanye was a good Christian boy who loved Jesus. Once in the spotlight though, Kanye's image and message quickly took a turn for the worse, ultimately leading him to become one of the biggest promoters of Illuminati symbolism and materialism, not to mention developing a god complex so huge it's virtually unmatched in the entertainment industry. He has won 8 Grammys, and in 2008 was awarded the hottest MC in the game by MTV, and even made Time Magazine's 100 Most Influential People in 2005. A critical boost to Kanye West's career was working for Jay-Z's Rockefeller Records, and he was considered Jay-Z's protege, while helping produce his 2001 album, The Blueprint. West's ego grew larger than his wallet as his career took off, and he became one of the highest profile rappers to start posing as if he had some connection to the Illuminati, wearing clothes with Baphomet symbols on them, name dropping the Illuminati in a few songs, and even saying he sold his soul to the devil. Kanye West also isn't shy about his God complex, appearing on the cover of Rolling Stone in 2006 as Jesus, wearing a crown of thorns, and later releasing a track titled I Am God on his Yeezus album, Yeezus being a perversion of the name Jesus. His God complex got so huge that after he failed to win Best New Artist in 2004 at the American Music Awards, he stood up and stormed out of the show saying, "I was the Best New Artist of the Year," and claimed he got robbed. At the 2006 MTV Europe Awards, he ran on stage as the award for Best Video was being presented to someone else and started arguing that he should have won. Then, of course, there was the infamous incident in 2009 when he stole the spotlight from Taylor Swift after she won an MTV Video Music Award for Best Female Video. After Beyoncé gave birth to Jay-Z's child, named Blue Ivy, Kanye gave Jay-Z a gold-plated human skull covered in gemstones valued at $34,000 for Father's Day. He even reportedly had it shipped via a private jet. Freemasons and other occultists often have a human skull on their desk or in their chamber of reflection to remind them of their mortality and impending death, to inspire them to achieve all of their goals in this life here and now, since they do not believe in the afterlife. In the season premiere of The Cleveland Show in November 2012, the episode revolved around hip-hop Illuminati, a secret society said to control pop culture and the music industry. Kanye West, Nicki Minaj, Bruno Mars, and will.i.am all lent their actual voices to the show and recorded the voiceovers as they played themselves in the episode. Kanye even rapped a little song in the episode about the Illuminati controlling society. He secured himself a part in pop culture forever when he knocked up Kim Kardashian, the Antichrist of entertainment, while she was still married to NBA player Chris Humphries. This Baphomet bimbo got a blood facial on her TV show in an attempt to maintain her youthful beauty, which involved basically smearing human blood on her face, reminiscent of Elizabeth Bathory, the Blood Countess from the Kingdom of Hungary, who in the 1600s murdered dozens of virgins so she could bathe in their blood, believing it would keep her young. After they were dating for a while, Kanye's baby mama also posted a few photos on her Instagram account to show off several new bracelets, one of which featured an all-seeing eye and another that people said looks like a Baphomet head, leading some to wonder if Kanye introduced her to the world of occult and Illuminati symbolism. This scumbag's antics and obvious egomania could have been sparked by studying occult philosophies from Aleister Crowley and others who teach that you are God or can become God by evolving your consciousness through various satanic practices. After all, it was Satan in the Garden of Eden who said that Adam and Eve could become like God by partaking in the forbidden fruit to open their eyes and mind to the secret powers Satan offered. That concludes his section on Kanye West. And I don't know if you've seen much of Kanye West's work. I'm not a big listener, and I haven't seen too many of his videos, but I have checked out some of the pictures of him performing. He's wearing a skirt with a Baphomet head on it, and just like Mark says in the book, him and his wife both have jewelry that has the Baphomet head on, like a ring with a Baphomet head, and just I think I saw him with pyramid rings or a picture of his hands at some type of award show with pyramid rings on that showed the Illuminati eye. There was an eye in the center of the pyramid on a ring that was on his hand. And I was just like, I mean, it seems pretty clear to me that they are definitely representing this symbolism, which I mentioned before. There's another book that Tex Mars writes called Codex Magica, which details the Illuminati symbolism. I highly recommend that you read the full book by Mark Dice, Illuminati in the Music Industry, and also check out Tex Mars, his book Codex Magica, and it will this stuff, which seems like, you know, some people just blow it off, hey, it's a coincidence, or, oh, they're just into that stuff. Well, I mean, if you really understand what it is, then you won't have that opinion, because you know what it is, and you understand why they're doing it. So, in my personal opinion, just based off of what I know and the research that I've done, yeah, you know, Kanye West is definitely a part of the Illuminati and what they are trying to do with society. And again, to the people who just kind of don't know about this stuff or just completely dismiss it as stupid, crazy conspiracy nonsense, it is real. I mean, these secret societies do exist. They do have a language of symbolism. This is why you're seeing this stuff. And even though you might not think that these artists are involved, you have to think, like, what is the most powerful thing you can do in society? One of them is to have influence. So if people aren't going to necessarily listen to a group of, like, really powerful men, like, you know, think of the heads of Wall Street and a lot of powerful people in society, they might not be the most appealing to, you know, look at as the masses, you know, to have, like, as a symbol, but artists are. So if you can control rap artists, if you can control people in the industry, then that's a huge way to get your agenda across, because you're using them as a puppet. They are more attractive to the masses than a guy sitting in a penthouse who's a Wall Street executive and, you know, who is the owner of huge corporations. Like the people who sit on the boards of these record companies and are the, you know, they control the power in the world. I mean, they are, when you actually look them up, you know, the Henry Kissingers of the world, the Rothschild family, the Rockefeller family, when you look at them, they're not the most appealing people. So of course they're going to get their agenda done by incorporating people who are going to be attractive to the masses. And that's why you see all this symbolism and stuff like that. So